Several years ago, in my endeavor to find out more about food deserts, started exploring the situation here in Dallas and meeting people who are on a similar quest. And some of us got together and realized that there might be something we could do about that. And from that was born Restorative Farms. I think what makes Restorative Farms so unique is our mission is kind of threefold. One, grow food the community can afford, but grow learning opportunities, educational, employment opportunities, and maybe career opportunities. And the difficult part of it, be able to pay for it by producing and selling what we actually grow here. Here at this site, we have 5 employees, and depending on the time of the week, 5 to 15 volunteers.
My name is Tyrone Day. My role here with Restorative Farms, I came in because I graduated in prison. I actually went to prison for 26 years. And I graduated top of my class at Trinity Valley Horticulture up under Professor Clint Perkins. So my role here is actually I'm farm director and manager of farm operations. I was incarcerated for many years. I got wrongfully convicted about 2 miles from here in South Dallas. Done like 26 years and 7 months in prison day for day. So here next week actually is the time that they actually gonna exonerate me, but it actually goes in after all these years that I was wrongfully convicted. I can't get my time back, but I can actually get my name cleared and get my, I've been living a good life since I've been home. I mean, I'm married, I get to spend time with my grandchildren, come back out here as a citizen, giving back and being a provider to my home and to the community. It makes me feel like, well, I met my purpose now.
There's so many things that are on the spreadsheet around a working commercial farm, but off the spreadsheet benefits are numerous, from community cohesion, you know, lower crime rates, just a real sense of community. So those are the things that we're striving for.
We've done a lot here with Restorative Farm. We brought communities and bridged the gap between races and all. With just gardening and farming here. So actually, since we've been here, there's a lot been done in this little plot. It's not really a little plot, we've extended this plot. We've done a lot as far as providing and assisting people who need to eat, bringing about programs of that nature there in the food desert. You have people from different walks of life working together for African-American community, for the Jewish community, for the European community. However, we're working together for one common cause to try to address the food desert issues.
My name's Michael Higgins. I'm the urban conservationist in North Central Texas. I started working with Restorative Farms 2 years ago. The farm is unique in that they are a hub to teach growers how to scale and grow food in their community. They bring new beginner farmers in and they help them grow food and continue to prosper their communities.
The NRCS has been very helpful in helping us fund a high tunnel, which we're standing in, which helps extend our growing season, start earlier and grow longer. They've also been helpful in providing funding and engineering to create a rainwater catchment system as well, which we'll be implementing shortly.
One of the opportunities is installing a water harvesting catchment to capture water when seasonal rainfall is not available to the crops. So we do that through capturing water, and it's in gallons, and folks can apply that when they need to.
Okay, NRCS, what I want to make clear with that is that the support system that as a partner, as a supporter for what we have going here, the infrastructure, some of the infrastructures for the tunnels or what have you, they've been a great help with that right there.
The NRCS has been helpful in providing us a lot of knowledge about soil health, the microbes in the soil and so forth. So we look forward to learning more about that and working with them.
At Restorative Farms, it's important to have NRCS assistance so we can help those urban small-scale producers address the challenges with urban production. So many of the different farming systems and some of the challenges, flooding, ponding, soil erosion, pest management. And so we're addressing those issues.
Oh, it's beneficial, what have you. It's just a growing entity that we want to be able to have. It's good to have them as a partner.
Well, it's been rewarding to watch our farmers who are community members develop month after month more and more confidence in what they're doing and take pride in what they're doing. And that's been very rewarding to see. And then when you see what it does for some of the children, you're in a community that's underserved, and very often young people feel a lack of control in their life. But when they see a small seed become a plant, become something put on their table, suddenly a sense of self-control starts overtaking them, and the ceilings rise for them in the thinking about the possibilities. All that's very gratifying.
The farm has been great to work with. They really help producers grow more food. I've actually sent new growers to restorative farms, and they've helped with transplants, helping them get started. So they're really a great food hub and advocate for beginner farmers.
There's something magical about particularly people in a very urban setting, to take a small seed and see it actually grow into a plant and then grow produce that they put on their table. And for them to understand they can do this year after year after year, it very often it's a game changer.